Hi, I'm Fred McNeil. You're watching QAC TV 7. The name of the show is Shorts and Sandals. Each week we go to a delightful place here in Queen Anne's County. We've gone up the Chester and down the Chester River on cruises. We've been at Terrapin Park. Today we're at one of my favorite spots, the Town Wharf area, right here in Centreville. And I think we've got the best guide we could have is Town Commissioner Tim McCluskey. Tim, thank you for being with us, okay? Not only is this probably one of your favorite spots, but it's also your extended backyard.
It is, as a matter of fact.
Hey, tell me what we got here besides a beautiful setting.
So we have about a 2-acre park here. The town bought this property in 2007. We were fortunate enough to get a couple $100,000 in waterway improvement grants where we were able to put in a boardwalk. We've got 10 finger piers. We've got a floating kayak dock here as well and a couple of other spots around. And we're really continuing to build out the park and make it a nice amenity.
And you had, I guess it was last year, I had the delightful opportunity. You had an outdoor movie. The place was packed.
It
right?
was.
The whole grass area was packed. Well, what we're going to do, folks, we're going to go visit some of the areas right here in this town dock area. And I want you to know, it's just a beautiful place to come sit with the family. There's swings and all types of goodies. And there's always a breeze here. Now, Tim, a lovely spot we are. Tell me what we're seeing as we stay right here.
This is the Coruscant River looking out, which would take you into the Chester River about 6 or 7 miles out. One of my favorite places here in Centreville. There's always some boats going out. There's always some birds coming in. We've got several nesting couples of osprey. There certainly are lots of bald eagles here as well, and a lot of great blue herons.
And a great place for the family, right? You can put a blanket out in the grass, all right? Or you can just sit on the boardwalk and you occasionally say, can you fish here, Tim?
Absolutely. Okay. And there's good fishing here. You know, my kids come down and really enjoy it. We've had actually several fishing contests where you get kids who have never fished before come down and they get to sit in the dock and pull up some fish.
And Mother Nature has been great to you. It looks like this whole area has gone green on us, right?
It has, as a matter of fact. We've got a great green lawn here. As you had said before, we did have a fantastic outdoor movie here last summer, and we hope to continue to do other family activities down here.
Tim, what's the procedure to use this? Can a group ask to use this, or is there a procedure?
Absolutely. You know, I don't know if there's a specific procedure to rent or to reserve this spot. We've got one of those for Millstream, and I think certainly they could come down and do the same thing for the wharf.
So if a church group wanted to have a picnic, if they just contacted the town and tried to make arrangements, that would probably be the procedure.
Absolutely. Okay. Right now, we don't have any electricity down here. We do have in our budget to do some improvements this summer. That would include having some electric brought out. We were going to put in some new ladders for some of the slips here as well to make them easier to get in and out of the boats.
And just like we see this young lady sitting down, it's a nice, quiet, relaxing place. And like I said, as we look out, we've got dogs being walked. We have a mom with little kids. And I see in the morning, people just park their car here and watch the sun come up and just kind of, like I said, the moment of zen.
Absolutely. And we've got people who will park their cars here and join people who are going out in the boats. So it's always being used, summer and winter. We've got the little playground over there that's always used as well. So this playground is actually, we brought this down here from Millstream Park. In 2009, we received a grant for a whole brand new park system, which we ended up putting the new one down in Millstream, and we had no place for this. So we brought this down here as kind of a catalyst to see if we can get some people down here. And as you can see, it's being used now, and it's really very popular.
And on a Saturday or Sunday, it's packed.
It is.
Now, I've come down here, and it amazes me. Oh, 10 kids with family, that type of thing. Now, there's the famous sledding hill in the background. Tell us about that.
That is. That's Mount Centreville. As you can see, it's not much of a hill, but that is really packed in the winter. And over the past couple of winters, we've had so much snow, it's packed from 7 a.m. until 9 o'clock at night.
And it's one of the few sledding places, maybe the only one in the Centreville area, right?
You know, it's great because it's not that long. It's pretty steep, so the kids get a good, quick run. They can build up some jumps. And they have a great time.
Tim, if people want to get more information on how to use this facility or have questions about it, who would they contact at the town office?
They would call Town Hall. Anybody there could answer. The phone number there is 410-758-1180, or they can go to our website, which is townofcentreville.org.
Tim, now we're in front of an office building. Tell us what's going on behind us.
So the town bought this office building in 2011. It's also a warehouse. We've actually rented out some of the spaces to private businesses that are complementary to the activity that we have on the outside, and we also have moved some of the town offices down here as well when we've grew out of the space that we have at our town hall and Lawyer's Row.
Is there room still available for rentals or not?
There is. We have one space here, a retail space on the front area. We've recently put in indoor bathrooms as well. The second floor has our finance office as well as our planning and zoning department.
So that's a pretty well-used building, isn't it?
It is. In fact, we all also have, as you can see over here, Centreville Outdoors, who's been renting for about 3 years now, and that's a kayak and fishing rental place. Okay. Got Bigby Shore Performances here. He's a pro baseball player, and he's actually rents out the warehouse where he provides baseball, softball, lacrosse, any kind of outdoor ball activity. The kids are there playing
every
day.
So all types of good stuff going on. One of the great things, Tim, as you walk along the shoreline here, there are these historic, tell us about these markers and what they're pointing out to the people who walk in this area.
So these are a series of interpretive historical markers that talk about the history of transportation and commerce in Centreville. Being that we're here at the wharf, back in the day, before there was any roads, obviously, before there was even railroads, the Centreville Wharf was a major commerce hub. Sure. Where boats would be coming in with products from Baltimore, and then they would be going back with the agricultural bounty. And right here, this helps to interpret what the wharf would have been like back in the 1700s, again, before there were trains. This was a part of a grant that we had received as well, and this is going along a pervious paver pathway that was also grant-funded, and there used to be large buildings here.
Right. When we first moved here about 40 years ago, there was still an old granary here or something. Mm-hmm. Yes, okay. So as you walk along, you can get to learn a little bit about the history of Centreville and this entire area and what a productive and very busy waterfront this is.
That's right. This is a set of several different panels, which as you walk uptown, there's one in front of the Board of Ed, there's some that are in front of the downtown historic courthouse, and then out on Pennsylvania Avenue, which talks about the railroads when the railroads were big.
Okay. Just another reason to come visit Centreville and come visit Queen Anne's County. Well, Tim, thank you for a wonderful guided tour.
Thanks, Red.
Next time I see you, I'm going to get you and Jim Moran out in the golf course and really get people talking, all right?
As long as you don't film it.
Okay. Well, I can't promise. All right. Thanks for joining us on QAC TV 7.